This equation has a real solution. This equation also has a real solution. But what if we add them up and we get square root of x plus square root of negative x, and that's equal to 2? Unfortunately, this equation does not have any real solutions anymore. And let's talk about why first. Let's consider the left-hand side, and I'm just going to call that to be f of x. And the deal is that we have to worry about the domain of this function. Whenever we have a square root, we will have to pay attention to the inside. We will have to first make sure that this x has to be greater than or equal to 0, because we cannot have a negative number in the square root, because otherwise we will get complex numbers. And for the second one, we will have to put this to be greater than or equal to 0 as well, but this right here is a negative x. So right here, divided negative 1 on both sides, we are going to need x has to be less than or equal to 0. But if you guys take a look right here, combining these two conditions, the only number that can make this work is when x is equal to 0. So you know what? In fact, this function is just a point, because we can only plug in 0 into here and we are only going to get the origin. So if you ever feel like the need to grab the origin, go ahead and just use this function. But now let me just tell you, of course, you guys saw the shirt already. We'll be talking about complex solutions for this, and this is how you can do it. So here we go. We see that we have a negative instead of the square root right here. So I'm just going to keep this as how it is. But then for this, I'm just going to put out an I. So we'll just say plus I and then square root of x, and that's equal to 2. Now let's go ahead and factor out the square root of x, and I'm going to write down parentheses 1 plus I first, and then square root of x, and that's equal to 2. And then I will divide this on both sides, and then of course we can just go ahead and square both sides. 2 squared, which is 4, and then 1 plus I squared, we will have to do 1 squared, which is 1, and then plus 2 times this and that, which is 2i, and then lastly, we do I squared, which is negative 1. And this and that cancel, and then we can also reduce this and that. So we will get 2 over I. But I don't know about you guys, but I don't like to be on the bottom, so let's multiply the top and bottom by I. And then we get this right here being equal to negative 1. So all in all, we see that x is equal to negative, and then we have the 2i. And now, here's a question for you guys. Is this the only solution? No. But if you see the whole process, it only gives us this one, right? So we will have to go back to the original equation. The deal is that this equation is symmetric, because here we have x for the input, and here we have negative x for the input. So that means if negative 2i is a solution, that means positive 2i will also be a solution. So I will just include that, and also x equals 2i. And then we are done. Okay, same deal. This equation has a real solution. This equation also has a real solution. But how about when we add them up? Lnx plus ln of negative x is equal to 0. Let me tell you, no more. No more real solutions. And let's talk about why. So let's do what we did earlier. Let's consider the function f of x being equal to ln of x plus ln of negative x. And remember, in order for us to get real numbers, we will have to make sure the input is bigger than 0. So the first condition is we have to make x being greater than 0. We don't have the equal sign here. And then pay attention to this right here. We will actually need negative x to be greater than 0 as well, meaning that x has to be less than 0. But if you look at these two conditions, is it possible for us to find a number that's bigger than 0 and less than 0 at the same time? No, impossible. So this right here is even worse, because earlier we have at least one point. Right now we don't even have any point. So this is like really like the empty graph. If you would like, it's just like the x and y axis. But of course, let's talk about how we can find the complex solutions. Can we do what we did earlier? We put out the negative. Yeah, because we can actually look at this as ln of negative 1 plus ln of x, and then you can actually work out the ln of negative 1. But for this one, you don't have to do that, because the key is this plus sign. Let's just go ahead and combine the logarithms. So nice, you'll see. So together we will have ln, and we are going to put these two together inside, and we are going to multiply them. So it will be x times negative x. And of course, this is still equal to 0. Now, x times this, we get negative x squared, and that's equal to 0. So you can see that the inside is actually always negative. So yeah, no real solutions for here. And we can actually solve this though. We can just exponentiate both sides. So this means negative x squared has to be 1. Divide negative 1 on both sides, and then just take the square roots on both sides as usual. And of course, don't forget the plus minus. Ladies and gentlemen, the solutions for this one is x is equal to plus or minus square root of negative 1 is I. Yeah, really cool, huh? All right, another one. First equation, e to the x is equal to 0. And let me tell you, no solution. Not even complex solutions. All right, and please do not say negative infinity, because negative infinity is not a number. So this one here has absolutely no solutions. And then for the second one, let me tell you, this right here, also no solution. Not even the complex numbers either. And please do not say positive infinity. And just like what we did earlier, what if we add them up? We're looking at this equation, e to the x plus e to the negative x is equal to 0. Let's talk about the domain this time, like earlier. Let's consider the function f of x being equal to e to the x plus e to the negative x. In fact, the domain for this one is so nice, because there's no restriction for what number you can use for x. So I will just write this down real quick. The domain is actually just all real numbers. So that's the symbol for that. And in fact, if you graph this, actually, let me come back here and just show you guys the graph for e to the x, which is of course the exponential graph, like so. And then e to the negative x is just the other direction, exponential decay. Cool. And you can just kind of add the graphs together, right? Because you can see that this is almost 0, and you add this, so it's going to curve up, and then likewise this. So you actually end up with something like this. Yeah, it's not a parabola. It's almost like a Cauchy function. All right, cool. So you see that we do have a curve, much better than earlier, right? But this curve will never touch the x-axis. That's why it has no, let me tell you, it has no solution. But for this one, we do have complex solutions. For this one and this one, they have absolutely no solutions. Even though it's the similar situation, you see the curve right here does not touch the x-axis. This curve here does not touch the x-axis. And you may think that there's like some imaginary solutions, but no, not at all, absolutely. But for this one, magically, yes. So have a look, let's find them all. We have a lot. So here is how we can do it. Let's move this to the other side. So we have e to the x, and that's equal to negative e to the negative x. And right here, let's get rid of the negative exponent by multiplying this equation with e to the positive x. This times this will give us e to the 2x, and then this times that will just give us 1, because the exponent adds out to be 0, so we have negative 1. Aha! How do we deal with this? Still go ahead and take the ln on both sides. This way, this and that cancel. But now the question is, how do we handle ln of negative 1? You want to know a quick way to do it? The quick way is, this is actually on my shirt already. We can write negative 1 in the polar form, namely e to the I pi. Yeah, so right here, we are going to get 2x is equal to ln, and then this right here is e to the I pi. I can prove to you guys that this is negative 1. You see? That's the proof. But the truth is, this is not the only way to get negative 1, because the pi is not the only angle in the polar plane that will give you this complex number to end up with negative 1. So the deal is that we look at this pi here, plus 2n pi. And in fact, you can do it now, you can do it later, up to you, but perhaps I'll just do it now. And if I do this now, I can cancel that, and I can just put on the entire thing right here. So ladies and gentlemen, let's just divide the 2 on both sides. So ladies and gentlemen, for this one, we have infinitely many complex solutions. Even the earlier these two equations, they were not possible anyway. Check this out. For this equation, in fact, we have infinitely many solutions. And I'll tell you, x will be equal to pi over 2, and that's actually the first angle that will make sine equals 1. But we have infinitely many of them because we can start from here and just keep adding 2 pi. So we can just say plus 2n pi, and now let's put down n is an integer right here. So wow, we have infinitely many solutions for this equation. Similarly, for the second equation, x is equal to 3 pi over 2, and then plus 2n pi, where n is an integer. Okay, so we also have infinitely many solutions for this. And again, we are going to add them up. Sine x plus sine of negative x is equal to 2. You think I'm going to do it for you? No! I'm actually going to leave this for you guys to think about.